Good morning, everybody. BTC Simmer here with you. Afternoon, good evening, no matter where you may be. You probably know what you're looking at right now. You're looking at the Cessna T-37B. It's been reviewed a few times by a few different YouTubers out there, as I've already seen. Probably don't know where we are. We're at some custom scenery. It's a Suffield airfield base outside of Medicine Hat, Alberta, Canada. This scenery is by Tyke from flightsim.to. So plan today isn't really to do a review of this aircraft. It's more take it up for a rip, see how it does, maybe skim the Trans-Canada. There's enough reviews about it, but we definitely will walk around it, have a look at it, see how well it's done, and play with it, and maybe even get it started to take it up for that rip. Be fun to skim the highway, like I was saying, but we shall see. It's a pretty neat aircraft. I'm not really into military aircraft. I don't believe in war. I don't believe in war has to happen. I think we're, as a species, we're smarter than that, a little more mature as well. We don't need to. The great things we could come about with getting along would be much better than war. So that's just some background information on myself. But I mean, war does happen, and it's unfortunate. And I don't want to go down the rabbit hole. But anyway, I do like this plane. It's a bit of fun. I did test it a couple times here, and kind of got familiar with it, so I could make a video of it. So anyway, guys, with that said, let's jump into the price BTC here. What are we at? We're at 28,436 American and around 38,167 Canadian. So hovering around that 28, I mean, one BTC is one BTC, guys. The great things that will be built when BTC is the standard. Imagine the world we could live in. All right, a couple headlines. Should we do some headlines? Let's see. What do we got? BTC price targets fix on 35K as Bitcoin eyes massive liquidity squeeze. 35K. That'd be nice. Remember, nor the noise, one Bitcoin's one Bitcoin. All right. Despite Bitcoin's 70% rally, historic under evaluation remains, explains crypto analyst. Any one of you could be a crypto analyst. You look at a chart and you make an assumption and make it a, you know, you're a crypto analyst. Bitcoin price analysis for April 11th. Let's see here. For April 1st. I did the other one there. There's not a whole lot of headlines here today. Memcoin Market Watch. That's more of an April Fool's kind of headline. Investment strategist Lynn Alden. ETH likely a security based on Howey test. Yeah, ETH I'm sure is a security. Guys, there's no one in control of Bitcoin. There's no CEO. There's no there's no central point of authority. So, you know, people often ask, what is Bitcoin backed by? I can send it to you. You can be on the other side of the world and I can send it under 10 minutes for a tiny fee, any amount. And no third party looking at looking down your back. There's one of the things I believe Bitcoin's backed by. Cap 21 million. Yeah, that's another thing. So there's a few other things. I'm not going to go down them all, but there's that. All right, let's get to the video now. Review this bad boy here. All right, walking out of our suite here at Suffield. You can see some custom scenery. This is by, I don't know, these buildings, if they're part of the sim or not, but he did a runway here, and I don't know if he did any buildings, but definitely the runway is nice. I believe it's runway 17. Let's have a look here. Yeah, it's 17 over there. So he did the taxiway and the runway, I believe. So there's something here to mess around with, because this is an actual airfield here in southern Alberta. So, all right. Looks like maybe a barracks or something. I have been here in real life. I went through the security checkpoint and everything, and been on the actual base myself. So, pretty neat place. Anyway, Let's go have a look at our Cessna. So this was developed in the 50s, put into service in 1956. I think it was used by about 20 countries. I think Pakistan still uses them. I'm not sure, maybe. Just took a few notes here. There's three versions produced. I think there's even a civilian concept, but it never went into production. Wingspan's about 33 feet. You can see this model's very well detailed as well. I'm trying to push controls, but they don't work right now. Two J69 T-25 engines. You can see they're right in the middle here, one on each side. Actually hard to see. There's one there, and there's one over here. So, very low profile. And this is a jet trainer, so. The whole point of this one is a Cessna T-37B. Front wheels are steered by hydraulics. Cable connected to the rudder, I believe. Or is the rudder hydraulic as well? I don't know. I don't know a lot about these type of aircraft. Did take some notes. 4560 thrust. 369 knots max cruise. And never exceed 415. Cruise speed's around 300. Mach 0.7. Yeah, about 20 countries used them. And this is by Vrille Plate. VRILLEAPLAT on flightsim.to. Link will be in the description. And other than that, how about we jump in, take it for a rip? We'll have a look around first at the finer details of it. So, Major Dan Schumann. You can see he's got a lot of details on here as well, and I mean even the rivets show up nicely. Let's see, fuel tanks, ground plug-in, I guess that is. I'm going to be using my stick for this one because this is stick controlled, so prepare for that. Yeah, it's very well done. I mean, this could have been a payware aircraft. Glad he released it freeware. Maybe leave him a tip. It is a nice, probably a lot of work done as well. You can see the landing gear wells here. The nose gear. And very well done as well. So yeah, that's the exterior of the plane itself. Nice looking little aircraft. And from what I've heard, it's a lot of fun to fly. I've tested it roughly a few times, but it's been my first serious test of it. Looks like the pitot tube there and intakes. All right, let's hop on up. Wonder how you would actually get up in there. Would there be like some sort of ladder or something? Or would you climb on the wing here and then hop in? Not 100% sure. Anyway, switch our camera view here and get things going. All right. Okay, so a lot of these gauges are obviously retro. Might have a hard time navigating with these. In case you couldn't tell, this is the airspeed indicator here. Attitude indicator over here, obviously, the VSI, your VOR altitude. So we're already at, just hit B there, 29.9292. All right. Don't have any traffic on. See that my rudder, right rudder is definitely sticking there. Toe brakes work. All right, stick works, that's good. Always a good thing. You can see my throttle's a little off center there. All right, so how do we get this thing going? Should we shut the canopy or should we fire the engines with it open? Let's leave them open. So here's your power here. And these, I believe, are your alternator generators. Boost pump. Inverter. I don't know if you can move that one. Maybe you hold and move it. Leave it on main. If you're really supposed to mess with that too much. Alright, let's see here. So boost pump is on, and then right ignition starter. You gotta hold this one. However you might need. Let's go to off. Let's go to that to on, and then this to ground. There we go. This is the one you gotta hold. See if any gauges come alive there. Looks like there's a load on the generator. Playing with the throttle, see if it does anything. That doesn't sound right. Let's try that again. Turn that to ground. Was to full. Had to use Control E for that, guys. That'll get her going anyway. You can hear it's very loud with this. Back in line here. This canopy close here. Okay, looks like we're in action here. I'm not sure why I couldn't get it started by the switches, but it wouldn't start, so let's turn on some lights. Should have maybe turned these on earlier. Got landing lights over here. Obviously your anti-collision down here. Strobe lights here, position. Funny because I got strobe light and position light, and position light only. Oh, I see. I'll leave it on that. See how the lights look from the exterior. Nice and bright. Those are the landing lights there. That's the taxi light. And beacon light there on the middle of the fuselage. And my strobe light switch doesn't seem to do anything. It's set to the anti-collision lights, which are right here, obviously, each wingtip. Alright, let's taxi out to the runway. Had the parking brake toggles wrong there. Let's see here. A brake on each wheel or something, or what? There we go. There's little mirrors here to move them around. Yeah, the scenery is custom. You can download flightsim.to. It's put together by Tyke. It's a Suffield air base outside of Medicine Hat. Alright, we're in position here. We'll turn on our landing lights. Off the taxi lights. Go ahead with full power. And gently pull back. See, there's two landing gear levers there. It does fly really good. It's nice and easy on the controls. See, we're gaining a lot of airspeed there. Trans-Canada here. It's obviously going west. Come back this way, back over to Suffield here. I'll let the throttle too low. Gives you the gear warning. See if we do like a spin or something. Look at how easy that is. Fairly simple for a plane like this. I don't fly these really, so I don't really know. Try to adjust the trim. It seems like it's there's the trim there on my stick. Just try to remember where we are here. I mean, it definitely has the power to do a lot more, go a lot faster than I'm flying it at. See the gear lights up there, that's pretty neat. The throttle back up to a certain level will go away. Maybe not. There. Just come back on the throttle a little bit there. Yeah, it's a lot of fun, this airplane. Freeware from Vril A. Platt, flightsim.to. Link will be in the description. This is the fun part about these planes. Do stuff like this. Top Gun style. Let's go on down to the highway here. Follow that road to go back, alright. And skim right along. There we go. Usually don't fly in this view, but today why not? I mean, it handles really well for freeware aircraft. I mean, wow. Alright, let's bring her back. See the smoke effects there? Uh-oh. Let's try to get our back in the air. Well, there we go. Just like that. All right, let's get back in here. Try to bring her back down for a landing. Probably too fast for the landing gear, but that's okay. Things we were doing should be alright. Go to that road and try and do a left base here. It's actually a very simple plane to fly. Handles very well. All the inputs are right there. Handles more like a, I don't know, like, kind of like a prop, I'd say. Has a Cessna feel to it, if you know what I mean. Get some flaps out there. Make sure our gear's down. Yes, it is. Come in here for a sloppy final. All right. Back on the throttle a little bit more there. Seems like I'm too fast and too high. One of the two or three. We got more flaps. A little late now, but that's okay. All right. Bring those flaps up and away. So that's the Cessna T-37B, guys. It's freeware from Rillaplat on flightsim.to. Lots of fun, give it a try. As you can see, I ran it right into the ground. but it flies real nice. And I probably could have did a better landing, but it... I don't know the limitations of this aircraft, so... kind of just rolled with it. Had a little fun. It's a fun day flight, so why not? And this airport is Suffield by Tyke. Just a strip and a taxiway, I think, is all he really did here, but it's definitely better than having nothing here, and it is a military base. Out by Medicine Hat, Alberta, Canada. So have a look at that if you want. Alright, brought it back in one or two pieces here. Alright guys, I recommend this airplane. Have a look at it. A lot of fun to fly. Kill the engines here. Control Shift E. Kill them off there. Oh, we gotta unlock the canopy here. There's one on each side. Lever there on both sides, and then you hit this button. Oops. It's right below the throttle there. If I can get to it. Move this up. There we go. Yeah, a lot of fun this one. Check it out. Very easy to do all those barrel rolls that everyone loves. Very, very easy. Right. Hop on out of here. External, we'll go to showcase. Showcase view. Yeah, a lot of fun this one. See, I took it up for a little rip. Turn off all the lights. No, the lights won't turn off in this view for me. Let me hop back into here. Those, and kill the power. Oh, I got the power on here. There. Obviously, I don't fly this thing at all, so... Thanks for bearing with me while I go through it all. Alright, a lot of fun guys. Check it out. T-37B, Cessna T-37B. Military aircraft developed in the 50s. Into production in 56. I think it's a jet trainer, I do believe. Have a look. Really plat on flightsim.to. And it's freeware, so. Enjoy guys. Remember, stack 'em sats. Thanks for watching.